Мікрофон. Мікрофон. Ми чуємо.
Мікрофон включи.
Sorry. I would like to thanks for nice introduction and also thanks to organizers of conference to have a talk on this nice conference. I would like to retell about some square matrices over commutative rings. To tell you the truth, the problem of classifying up to similarity of square matrices over commutative ring with identity, which is not a field, are very difficult. In most cases, it is unsolvable because it is wild. As for ring of residual classes, this result was received by Vitaly Bondarenko in the first article. The special cases of matrices of small size considered by many authors, for example, in three articles above. We see that two matrix of a commutative ring with identity of same size is similar if there exists some invertible matrix over ring R, matrix C, such that first matrix A is equal C in the minus one power multiplied by B multiplied by C. When the matrix is invertible over the ring, it is well known. It is enough to check determinant of matrix C, of square matrix C. If it is invertible over ring R, then the matrix is invertible. When we can describe matrices up to similarity, then important place occupied by so-called irreducible matrices. We see that square matrix of size n is reducible over commutative ring R with identity if it is similar to matrix of such form, where on a diagonal block we have square matrices. Otherwise, we say the matrix is irreducible. It's well known that if A be a field, then matrix M, square matrix of size N, is reducible if and only if characteristic polynomial of this matrix is reducible. But if we go to the commutative ring case, then reducibility of characteristic polynomial only necessary condition for reducibility of matrix. It is easy to show that if a matrix is reducible, then a characteristic polynomial is also reducible. During studying investigation of modular matrix representation of finite group over commutative local ring with Jacobson radical generated by one element, non-zero element T. We together with my scientific supervisor, Petroho Divok, found two matrices, square matrices, which are irreducible over this ring. This matrix was of any size. So the result was interesting to construction of irreducible matrix representation. If you look at the first matrix, it is easy to show that characteristic polynomial of this matrix is irreducible. So the matrix also irreducible. But for the second case, if for example, T square is equal zero, that for size greater than 2, we have a reducible characteristic polynomial, but irreducible matrix. To go on with investigation, we consider some general cases of matrices. We consider such matrix as here, where in each row and each column, we have only one non-zero element, such a matrix in general called the monomial matrix. But here, we also indicate places where appeared non-zero elements, and we assume that there are arbitrary number of elements T on these non-zero positions. So the question is when such matrix is reducible and when it is irreducible. For example, if we consider matrix of psi square matrix such form of size 4, we also assume that in matrix appeared at least one identity and at least one T, because otherwise the answer certainly depends of properties of residual class field. So it is a field case. For matrix of size 4, we can say using previous results that matrix of this form with one element T and matrix of second form with three element T are irreducible. Then we consider matrix with two elements T and try to understand is this matrix irreducible? But unfortunately, it is not irreducible, it is irreducible. We found such matrix C that this multiplication is equal reducible form, where we have on diagonal matrix block 2 by 2 matrices. I would like to retell about idea of this proof. We use this idea very often when try to prove that matrix is reducible or irreducible. Of course, it is not very interesting to find the invertible matrix to matrix C. We usually multiply to the left hand this matrix equality by the matrix C. So we consider such a more simple matrix equality. It is interesting to know that we have to find only first two columns because of course these two columns must be part of invertible matrix, but it is not very difficult task when two columns is a part of invertible matrix. So we can omit the last two columns and receive more simple matrix equality. Using zeros in the last matrix, we can simplify this matrix equality, which in some sense equivalent to first matrix equality. So we check these products, we find these two columns, and we show that matrix M with two elements T is reducible. Moreover, more general, we see that this runs also not only for commutative local ring with principal Jacobson radical generated by element T, but also for any commutative ring with identity and for any element T from ring R. More general, we also found that the matrix of any size n, square matrix of any size n of a commutative ring with identity for any element T from ring R is reducible if size of matrix N and number of elements K is not K prime. More, this result was received with Ruslana Denis, now she named Cimbolenets. Moreover, we show that in reducibility form on the left up corner, we receive the matrix of considerate form of smaller size and another number of elements T on non-zero positions. We begin to investigate matrices of smaller size. We considered many cases, and in some of them, we have a reducible case which follows from last result, and we have irreducible case which follows from result, joint result with Petrov-Divok. We also consider such two matrix of size 5, and we had proved that these matrix are irreducible. I think it is not very interesting result written here, because when we consider the size of 7, we find a contradiction of this assumption. The assumption was that matrix is reducible if and only if size of matrix and number of elements T is not coprime. We find matrix square matrix of size 7 with three elements T, of course, 7 prime number and 7 and 3 is prime, but matrix is reducible. If we assume that generator element of Jacobson radical of commutative local ring R on which we considered the matrix is a nilpotent element of second power, T square is equal to 0. So when we go on, we very often with Vitaly Bondarenko, we begin to consider more general case when the matrix M on its non-zero position has not only one and T, but T in any power. The exponent may be zero else. So we begin to consider such matrix and try to understand when this matrix are reducible. First, we shown that matrix M is reducible if size of matrix N and the sum of all exponents of element in non-zero position of matrix M is not coprime. Moreover, we can show that in reducibility form in the left up corner, we received the matrix of similar form, but a small size and another powers, another exponents in a parameters of this matrix. This result by Vidarenko, Maria Bortos, Ruslana Denis, and myself. When we go on investigation, we consider matrix with such form, but with exponents 0 or 1. Then we consider this case in some equivalence, it is all interesting case. So when we consider this case and the matrix reducibility cases following from previous result and irreducibility cases following from result with Ruslan Adinis, we have to consider these two cases. And we see that in these cases, matrices are irreducible. So we have again a result similar to previous matrix of such form is reducible over the ring R, where R is commutative local ring with Jacobson radical generated by non-zero element T, is reducible if and only if the size of matrix and sum of all exponents coprime, is not coprime. So we again have a contradiction in the sets of square 7x7 matrices. Then we assume that exponents can be 0, 1, or 2. Of course, we assume that the t square is not equal to 0. And we consider such cases when we omit reducibility cases and the casing following from previous result directly or not directly. We have for size 3 such two cases. Well, in these cases, it proves that matrix is reducible. And for size 4, we, after omitting known cases, we also have to consider that 7 cases, and we have proved that in these cases, the matrix are irreducible. This result was received with Maria Bortos and myself. But more interesting, the size 5, in which we found square matrices, which is reducible, but for which the size and sum of all exponents are not coprime. Are coprime, but matrix is reducible. Now consider more general case for size of matrix, but assume at first that the reducibility of matrix has a special way. We say that the matrix of such form as we considered previous hereditary reducible if it is similar to matrix of same form in the upper left corner in reducibility form. We know that we have such hereditary reducibility if n and k is not coprime, but we consider this reducibility in all cases and try to ask when the matrix M is hereditary reducible. Together with Milan Dimko, we consider such matrix at first over discrete valuation domain. It means that R is a commutative local ring with Jacobson radical generated of a non-nilpotent element. If a generator element is non-nilpotent, we can use characteristic polynomial, and show that this polynomial is irreducible. So the matrix also irreducible, not even hereditary irreducible, but simply irreducible. So the matrix N is reducible over R if and only if N at K is not K prime. This result holds for any size of square matrix M. When we go on, I think together with Milan, we received a very thin result as for me, because we prove that if R be a commutative local ring with Jacobson radical generated by element T, T can be nilpotent by when T in the power of greatest integer of fraction K times N minus K divided by N plus one is not equal zero, then the matrix N is hereditary reducible if and only if N and K is not coprime. The greatest integer function from this number is not very big. For example, if we use Cauchy inequality, we can say that this number not greater than greatest integer from n divided by 4 plus 1. So we can construct the many matrix which has reducible characteristic polynomial but which is hereditary irreducible. For example, if we consider previous two matrix of any size, using this theorem, we have to assume for this hereditary irreducibility that such number, greatest integer plus one, now it is equal only one. And if T is not equal zero as previous result, we have the matrix is hereditary irreducible. From previous result, we know that this matrix also irreducible. But for other K, we have many new statements. I think that for matrix 7 by 7, we also shown that if we have five elements T or four or three, then matrix are hereditary reducible. If we have six elements T or one elements T, we know as in previous statement, that this matrix is irreducible. So using a result with Milan and Co, we can say that in all these cases, matrices are hereditary irreducible. If we assume that T in the second power is not equal zero, in previous one for number of elements T, 5, 4, or 3, we know that if T square is equal to 0, that matrix is reducible. So the answer when matrix M is reducible very depends of degree of nilpotence of elements T. But for me, it is very interesting. Some years ago, I talked with some scientist, Artemovich Orest, what is it, the interesting result in algebra? I think it is interesting result, because Oleg Artemovich said me that if result is interesting, to be interesting, result must be unexpected. Here we have unexpected result for matrix with two non-zero elements T. Because if T any non-zero generator elements of commutative local of radical Jacobson of commutative local ring, it's mean of any degree of nilpotence. The matrix of odd size with two elements T is irreducible. It is all what I want to say now. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Professor.